Thornely Manor. Here we are, Auf Wiedersehen Pet Series 2. You've got to do up that old house. Well, this is the old house. Real name Beesthorpe Hall in Caunton, Nottinghamshire, near Newark. And Thornely Manor is the name it took in the series. Many people always remember it. You know, it was a classic series. Sadly, we lost Gary. But many things on this place have remained original, even the gatepost. Still the same. You go inside, you know, the windows, some of the paint even, you know, it's still the same after they left it all those years ago. And we're going to have a look around it, so let's have a look. Main front, where basically most of the filming happened, I think. Front of the house, arrival, police turning up, Ali Fraser coming, and many other scenes. Pull up from going back to Asda, so all these different scenes. But as you look around the house, and as I've been shown around the house in the past and today, it's almost all the same. So as you look here, so I got my car parked there, approximately where Wayne's BM was. You remember that nasty customs man? Didn't know many letters, did he? Do you know the one's FO, eh? Do you know FO? I didn't think you did, mate. Off he goes. Takes the BMW. See the side, there's actually a couple of garages and this and that, but you don't really see that in the episode. It's like another couple of gates that lead to it, but this, your main frontage was the main focus. And you remember you had that tower just up here. Okay then, here we are at the side of the house, and obviously in the filming, the trellis here wasn't there. We all know that, because you're loyal fans, you're going to be watching this if you're a loyal fan. So obviously the trellis wasn't there. The main sort of focus of this was when Oz had come back having his fun and games with the village wife, as I'll call her. It actually turned out to be the wife of the customs chap that took Wayne's BM, so good on you there, Oz. And Pringle shopped him, didn't he? But there you go, this, you know, this is it. Enjoy, let me get out of the way, just enjoy. This is what it's like today, with the sun out. This is our, you know, we want to see it. Because every time we come here, it's normally bloody raining, which is the time before, but here we go. Obviously, as you swing round, your tower was up here. And Colin, the son of the owners, has just shown me some very nice pictures of it going up, which we'll hopefully get in on the video. And this is basically where the tower stood. And been told it actually stood higher than the chimneys. There was a ladder right in the middle of it. It was a really tough sort of scaffold type frame, but tougher than scaffolding, the real scaffolding, like double the width, double thickness. And there's a big ladder in the middle of it. You could go up if you had the guts, and you know, you could climb it basically. Here's the back of the gardens. And the birds are chirping as always. But as we go further on, as we will, we'll see where the lads sat when they had the tea breaks and they told Hedgehog to pass message on to Fraser. Let's have a look. Here's your kitchen windows. Straight in there, straight in. I'll explain a bit about that when we go in. Here's the main bit where they used to sit. There you go, look. Door the same as always, windows above it, same as always. Almost exactly like it was, even the pump. Pump, same as always. Window where they broke in. And the little doorway down the side, little sort of, like an alleyway. It's actually a separate bit of the building that's got a front door down there. And I don't think this fence was there on the filming. It wasn't like corned off like this. Now as we turn around, this is how we are from the back door. You remember, what obviously once as grown as this, because it appeared to be quite flat, like it was derelict. And always remember on my first visit here, Mrs. Bellamy. Mrs. Bellamy, that was a character. But on the first visit here, Mrs. Matthews says the fire was about where the tree was. It seems as if it may have been closer, but the lady was here and I wasn't. But you got the. I don't know if it's the same bench, I don't think so. Basically looking out to the back there. And if we go a bit further up, you can actually see in the background. Let's have a look. There you go. That wall. Now, I'd have to double check the episode here and possibly pop it up on the screen on the final video, but I swear that's where Mrs. Bellamy was walking the dog. Down she came, told the lads that she thought they were breaking into the property the day before. And we know different, don't we? But you know, this is it. This is it. The broken in window. Probably still got a screwdriver mark there somewhere. Yeah, the pump's still there, the main back door. And just along here somewhere, somewhere like that, is where the kitty appeared, who actually lived here at the time on the episode. So I had to keep the cat locked up, but kitty got in there. I forget the cat's name, but yes, got in shot. Now in a classic episode. Okay, round here somewhere out the back. Possibly this way. You remember the scene on the video, Kenny Ames playing golf? Just been told by Colin that they actually had, you know, some sort of little bunker that they could pick up and then pick up again and drop down. And they had it out here somewhere. And that's where it looked like he's having the golf lesson. But just spin it round here somewhere. I'm sure there's people online that know where this is. There probably is. That's where I've read about it somewhere, but all in this back garden. A pretend bunker was put down, or a movable bunker I should say, because it was sand. Got that wall going along the back. And yeah, here's your golf lesson basically. You'll have to look back on the episode to check the angle of the house, how it was. But yeah, back of the property, the golf lesson. And you look down, and obviously that's where they all sat. Kitty got in shot, breaking in, etc. That's where it all was. Okay, we're going to head in the house in a minute, going to go in the kitchen, going to go in the cellar, going to look at the ghost corridor, going to look at the room where Nev went looking for Oz, and he come out of the wardrobe, didn't he? Turned in, he was Dracula. And going to go up above as well, from the top rooms, where Oz is talking to Neville through each window on about a hedgehog, and our pricks are on the inside of Land Rovers, eh? Range Rovers. Okay, here is your kitchen. Nice beautiful windows here. And over there, in front of where the door was and the oven, they actually built it up with some bricks, made an old fireplace. Art department got on it, made it look nice and old. And you see that looking quite nice and old in the episode too. But as finding out recently and today, this kitchen and another building in Bunny was actually used in like the same scenes. So they'd film some here, film some there, merge them together as if it was looking like it was in the same room. Even so, this is what could be referred to as your Thornely Manor kitchen. And where the water come out the tap. It didn't look too pretty at first, did it? But there you go, that's your kitchen. Okay, descending into your cellar. Bear in mind we didn't see all the cellar, because you don't really need to, I suppose. But this is going into your Thornely Manor cellar. There you go, here's one bit. Here's your second bit. And of course, as everyone knows from the episode, here is your videos where they were found. No bottles of old wine. That's just, it's a little bit muddy, so we have to be careful. Now, on the episode, it looks really big. That wide angle lens, whatever, I don't know. But, this is basically your video shelves, as I'll call them. Them videos any good, mate? Nah, sling them. Won't be anything worth watching, I suppose, he says. Something along the lines. But this is it, this is the place. On the first visit, I didn't see this when I came here in September 11. Here you go. In the bricks, as I'll say. Not in the flesh, in the bricks. Beautiful. That's going back again. So as you get down the bottom of the steps and you turn straight, you got room to the left, you got room in front, and you got video room, basically, where they were found. Quite a large cellar. And there's your steps going back up again. Been quite descriptive here today, but I want you to, you know, to see it, to see what other people haven't seen. Oh, here you go. Ah. Obviously it leads out to the garden. Extensive cellar, extensive cellar. Let's have a look. There's night vision. Yeah. Bit creepy. A little bit creepy. Because it's so quiet. But yes, here's the cellar. Okay. Right. Okay, God, it looks scary on here. I'm going to go up, wipe our feet. Then I'm going to go to the bedroom where Nev went to look for us. We're going to then go to a ghost corridor. And then we're going to go up above where they had the conversation about a hedgehog when he arrived. And we'll see where we can go from there to the room where the lad slept. And then we'll see what happens after that. Okay, up your main stairwell just here. Yeah. Through there and to the left is your ghost corridor, as we'll call it. We'll look at that in a sec. Let's go. You remember this? Nev comes up. Where's Oz? Let's go down here. Okay. Oz is missing. Where is he? And there he is. He's down in the wardrobe on the episode. And obviously this was an empty room. With not a lot in it. As I look out the window, you see your main drive. And what could be referred to as a roundabout, I suppose. But your round grass. Along with that dodgy car. But yes, this is the main room. Just into a closet. Just into a closet. Must have been somewhere about here for your wardrobe, sat on the floor, and out of all of them, it's going to be Oz, isn't it? He's going to be sleeping. So as we come out, we turn right, and there we go. Looks like you're going through this door, but you're not. You turn through this door. There you go. There's your ghost corridor, as we could call it. Right down the end, the windows above, we can see the roof with the little steps going down. Okay. Ghost corridor. Let's let it close. There you go. Okay, the steps going up lead up to the bit where Dennis and Oz was, and also Dennis's office. But just a quick backtrack. We go backwards, you turn back to the stairs, and you've got a room to the left which wasn't seen in the episodes. But on my last visit, Mrs. Matthews told me this, well, it's a bathroom, this was a makeup room. They had mirrors in here, they had the bulbs around the mirrors, as you can imagine, probably like in the back of a theatre. And this is where all the makeup took place. There we go. So let's go back up. Just have a quick look out your main window. Here's your gardens. There you go. Back up towards the main door here, past your ghost corridor door, and up the steps. Okay, heading up towards Dennis's office and the room where we saw Oz working at the start of the episode where Hedgehog pulled up. It's just one of them at the side of the house, lean to the back. Okay, down this little corridor, here's your magic. Here's one room. Decorated as such, I'm told, because a little kid used to sleep in here. I don't know whether it was granddaughter or niece, but obviously a child's room before. Not before the filming, obviously. But in recent years. Okay. Let's have a look out. There you go. Bit of old concrete ball. A nice beautiful look down to the drive and the gate in, down to the car. And look at that, you can even see the road in the distance. Lean to Ollerton or back to Newark. Right, let's shut the window. From the look of it as well, the same windows, the exact same windows, 86 paint on them. Colin says some have been repainted, others actually got painted shut. But here we go, down to what was Dennis's office. Now at first visit, Mrs. Matthews said that this was the room Oz was in. I'd have to check the episode, that's the room Oz was in. And he shouted out the window. I've just been told today that that room we've just looked in was Dennis's office. But on the first visit here, I was told this room was Dennis's office. I'm tempted to think it's this room myself. This wasn't one where they talked through the windows. But this was your office of Dennis, apparently, according to Mrs. Matthews. Leads out to that same little corridor. And we never actually saw this room. But that leads, obviously, to the back garden. Massive room, absolute massive. Bit of a funny floor, not exactly level. But, you know, it's an old building. There you go, leads out opposite Dennis's office. Random cupboard. Okay. Where they were working. I swear either Oz or Dennis for this one. But it was one of these two rooms, I'm sure. One was looking out this window. And one was looking out this window. Talking to each other as he pulled up below. Okay, back downstairs. Quick stop on the stairs. Here's your back garden. Here's your back garden. Beautiful. Down the steps. Here, turn, there's your front door. I remember in the episode we never got to see much through this door, just like a living room.
what looks to be directly below the ghost corridor on the main sort of stretch here. And all that wood that's been pulled off in the episode, you remember? Moxey bending down. And then the policeman, he came through there, didn't he? Got all the stuff come down on top of him. As we go through, you don't always realise this, but it's another room before you get to it. You go through one little room, and then, because I always thought it was into the room and he was there, but it's through this room, and there you go, into where the lad slept. Into the master bedroom, they could have called it, I suppose. This is where they slept. This is the boy. All those shelves, as was there in the episode, still there today. All leading out to the windows. Colin told me there was scaffolding put in here at the time. Obviously the wallpaper changed several times and put back to normal and put to tatty and then put back to normal when they went. The piano was here all along, but not in the episode. It did live in the house at the time. The piano was moved while the filming went on, then put back afterwards. Now today, I mean, you see a drunkard here and the door. But many people have been here, always going to remember this space, aren't they? Always going to remember that space. That's where Wayne slept. Oh, the lads used to sleep down here. Remember Bomber carried that old rug in, put it down. You've got Dennis talking just here about Moxie's new name, Brendan. But you know, this was the room. It's hard to believe when you stood in it, it really is. Because you know, this is where it happened. This is where they were when such a classic was being bloody made. And now, you know, I'm in it. Nice marble fireplace. Couple of the old lamps there, I don't know if they were there at the time. They look about the right style. Big radiator. I don't know if that was in the episode. I don't think it was it? I'll have to double check that. But this is your main room where many of it went on. Now as you go through here, you didn't see this on any of the programs, any of the episodes. This is your, it's like a little greenhouse. Just built on the side. Your main window's looking out to the trellis, where Oz and Moxey were looking in when they first ever arrived. And as we can see, the sun's out again. For once, the weather's on our side. So, we've pretty much gone everywhere we've gone in the filming, with the filming here today. We've gone where they've filmed. So, let's head back outside, do a couple last bits. And we'll say farewell, lads, to those of you who've sadly passed on. Gary and Bomber. Or should we say Gary and Pat and Wayne and Bomber. But it's been good to come back. The first visit was ever so slightly brief because you feel you're intruding on the time. You don't want to take up too much of time, you don't want to be bothering them. But they're kind enough to let you in, walk around, take footage, take pictures, and they're more than happy. So, farewell for now, Thornely Manor. There you go, old painting of the place, and an old picture. How it was before the trees came. It's beautiful, isn't it? And to think that ITV said that this wasn't quite big enough. But they used it anyway, thank God.
Okay, well, sadly it's that time of day again. Car keys are out, 3:30 in the afternoon. We got here about 2:00, so, you know, been here a little while. And it's time to say goodbye for now to Thornely Manor. Just look at it, you know, you don't want to leave here because this is TV history, isn't it? You don't want to leave, but you know, you don't own the place, you can't stay, and that's that. Many people come here and in a way they're sort of living a dream, they're getting to see where it was done, you know. And sadly, obviously, with Pat Roach passing in 2004 and Gary in 86, you know, you can't ever meet them all, not unless they're all up there and we do go up there. But when you can come and see a place like this and, you know, see where it was all done and be told, you know, oh, this was done, then it was put back, and that was wallpapered, and then it was teared off again. You know, it's different. It's something you don't see every day, something you don't hear every day all the time, not even on the internet. But look at it, just out in the middle of nowhere, outskirts of Nottinghamshire, almost near Newark, and it's just peaceful, tranquil, silent in many cases, just, you know, animal noises, Thornely Manor. All an Auf Wiedersehen pet fan would want, especially a loyal Auf Wiedersehen pet fan who thinks series 1 and 2 are obviously the better ones. But, you know, we can't change the past. And we're just glad that we did it here and that we can still come here at this time and come and see the place. And, you know, it's beautiful in real life. And the good thing is with it still being beautiful, it's still quite a bit that's the same. And you think, well, you know, they changed it since mid-80s. I think, well, why change it? It is Thornely Manor, all right, it's Beesthorpe Hall in real life, it's a family home. But, you know, authenticity-wise, there's still quite a bit here. The only bit that doesn't remain at all, for obvious reason that loyal fans will know of, is the tower at the back. They wanted to make it have a certain look in the programme, so they had to have the tower made, build here, put it up, keep it in the programme while it was filmed, and then take it back afterwards. And, you know, obviously that's what was done. But apart from that, there's just little add-ons, like the trellis. And in the cellar, maybe not an add-on, but, you know, it's bigger than what you think when you see it in the programme. Same with the back garden. The back garden's actually quite extensive, and not many people know there's a house behind it. You don't really see that unless you really, you know, go up the footpath a few paces. But all in all, you know, it's one hell of a place. I hope the Auf Wiedersehen pet fans like this. All right, we ramble on a bit, but, you know, a classic is a classic. And for it to get this attention after all these years still, especially with regards to fans and visiting the locations, I think that says something quite good about a programme, which you sadly do not see in today's programmes. But that's life in today. Shown around by the son of the owners, Colin. Thank you very much, Colin, if you do see this online. It's greatly appreciated. You know, honoured to come to Thornely Manor. I know it's obviously Beesthorpe Hall in real life, but with regards to the telly history, this is what many people see it as, and, you know, it's great to see it almost original as it was to back in 86 when they'd finished filming. But here we go. Big bee hovering around my camera. Gordon Bennett, he's a big one. And he's off. You remember that episode, Customs Officer? Wayne? You know, F.O.? Well, I think... maybe it's time I did that here at the minute. Time. This is the second visit I've ever done here. September, I think the 7th, 2011. About October, November, December, January, February, March, April, May. 8 months and one day since the last visit. Can't believe it's that long. First visit was, you know, a nice look around. Quite a few stories. Second visit today, the son showed me around, Colin, one of the sons. Quite a few stories again, because he wasn't here during the filming, he was actually at university and he used to pop back now and again just see the changing of the house and see what place was the kitchen for that week. But it's been hell of a walk around. I'm sorry for a bit of rambling here and there on the clips, but, you know, I want people to understand what was done in what room and do you remember this, do you remember that. And, you know, it's hopefully been an informative video on this new AUF pet website online, just to, you know, let people see what was done, where it was done, what's changed, you know, since doing it, like the trellis and things like that, and the fact that the tower was never real, it was just you know, added in there for the TV. Colin tells me that someone from the council came after the telly had been and gone with the episode and said, oh, I understand you've built a massive structure at the back of your property. I said, oh, yes. I said, oh, it's a listed building, you can't do that. He says, well, go and have a look. Where is it? That's it, mate, you've got no tower sat there. I said, I don't think we can do anything then, can we? No, you can't, go back. Go and find Edgehog. He's someone of that calibre, from what I can tell. But, yeah, fortunately we've got to call it a day for Thornely Manor. I hope people have seen the video, found it a bit informative, you know, learned stuff they possibly didn't even know, I don't know. But when you do see the place in the flesh or in the bricks, as I could say, it is a hell of a change from seeing it just on the TV. Some things look bigger on TV, other things you look at and you think, Jesus, that is quite a size in real life. But, you know, it's got to come to an end, I'm afraid. We're going to end the video here. If you plan to visit Thornely Manor in the future or Beesthorpe Hall, I'm not sure whether it'll be allowed or not. The reason being is because the people that own it at the minute, Colin and his brother, they're selling up because it's a bit too big for them. And new owners are apparently very quick sorting things out, or what will be the new owners, you know, with regards to surveys coming round and bits and bobs. So it may have a new family in it soon. Whether they'll be as accommodating as the Matthews family have owned it for 35 years, I don't know. So it may be farewell for now for Thornely Manor, for me at least. And depending how quick this clip gets online, if it's not long after May the 12th, I suggest you get in touch with Colin Quick via the Beesthorpe website and the contact link. But for me, Tim Wagstaff, your rambling guide for today's Thornely Manor visit, I'll say peace out, and I hope you've enjoyed it. I'll see you later.
Seeing as you're so bloody good at initials, how about F.O.?
Don't know that one.
Didn't think you would. Say anything, Arthur. I want you to know we totally understand, and we'd probably have done the same in your position. You know, the wife's done a runner, some topless bit of crumpet's got its legs wrapped round your neck.
Not only are you rubbish, but you talk rubbish as well. I'm going to call the police.
I wouldn't do that if I were you, old son. They might be interested in seeing this. Remember a little party at Thornely Manor? Kenny Ames and a bird called Pee-wee and this bloke with a video camera? Yes. Mr. Arthur Tiger Pringle. This is your life.
da, 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 da.
Yes, it started a while ago, just strangers thrown together, helpless heroes caught in a dream. Boy, we made such a crazy team. Out of luck and out on a limb, we saw each other through. Left it off, man, we shared a few. Back with the boys again. Even splitting up, going on solo, chasing circles and getting nowhere, longing for the way we were. One for all and all for anyone, as long as they played the game, sharing chances and taking all the blame. Back with the boys again. Get ready, we're going.